Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to answer the question, how do I count chiral centers? So what we're going to be looking for is a carbon with four different groups attached to it. That's what a chiral center is going to look like. An example here is we have a carbon in the middle. We've got four different other atoms attached to it. A non-example would be a carbon with four of the same atoms attached to it. So if we have a carbon with four hydrogens, that would not be a chiral center. Even if I put in a fluorine and a bromine, that would still not count as a chiral center because I still have these two hydrogens. So we need four different groups or four different atoms attached to the carbon. We'll take a look at this big molecule. This is a question you could see would be to look at this molecule and say how many chiral centers are present. What I'm going to start by doing is circling all of my carbons. So here are all of my carbons. These little bends in the line show me that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. So some of these may be chiral centers. I have to kind of look at some rules to figure out whether or not they are. I'm going to be using the process of elimination. The first thing I'm going to do is look for double or triple bonds. An example would look like this. I have two carbons here and here. They're both attached to a double bond. So I can eliminate both of those carbons. They cannot be a chiral center, either one of them, because it can't be chiral if it doesn't have four groups. So this carbon just has a hydrogen, a chlorine, and then this group attached to it. So it only has three groups, so of course we can't have four different groups. So looking back at my molecule that I'm trying to analyze, I can eliminate some of these. I can eliminate this one right here because it's attached to a double bond. Still looking at the process of elimination, I'm now going to be looking for carbons with space for two or more hydrogens. So we've got a bunch of examples on this molecule. This carbon right here has space for two hydrogens sticking out there. Same here, here, and here. All of those carbons have spots open for two hydrogens. This one doesn't. This one has three other groups shown attached to this carbon, and that would just leave space for one hydrogen. But this one could have three hydrogens, two hydrogens, this one could have three open spaces. Out of those four available bonds, three of these could be hydrogens. So it can't be chiral if there's more than one hydrogen, so that's why I'm looking for those carbons that have space for two or more hydrogens. I'm saying space because the hydrogens aren't usually shown in, I just have to kind of see that there's two open spots there. So if I look at this carbon, I see I could fit two hydrogens here. Not here, there's just space for one. Here, there's just space for one. But here, again, there's space for two. So I'm looking at these two carbons. Once I've eliminated all of those other carbons, I'm going to just double check. Now that I have these as my answers, I have to check, do I really have four different groups? And I do. I have my OH, I have my hydrogen, which is not drawn. And then if I can just visually see that this side and this side are two different arrangements. They are not identical. So same thing for this carbon. I've got my OH, I've got my hydrogen that's not drawn in, but I know it's there. And then I have two different sides. These two, the most obvious way is like looking at this phosphorus. I can tell just looking at it visually, those two sides are different. So I do have four different groups attached to each of these carbons. So my answer is going to be that I have two chiral centers. So let's look at another example. The question again will be how many chiral centers are shown in the molecule. I'm going to start by circling all of my carbons. There's a lot of them in this one. So I can jump right into eliminating any carbons touching a double bond. I've got three double bonds, so I'm going to be eliminating on both sides of the double bond. None of those carbons can be chiral. So that cuts out some of them. My next thing is going to be to take out any carbons that have two or more hydrogens. Well, this carbon is only attached to one group, so it has space for three. This one has space for two. This one has space for three. This one has space for two. We are left with just this one chiral center. Let me just double check if it really does have four different groups. This is my central carbon. I've got one group here. I've got a hydrogen sticking out there that I know that I have. And then I want to see if these two sides are the same or different. And I can see especially because of this oxygen on one side, but also even just this double bond, they're two different sides. So yes, it does count as four different groups attached to my carbon, which means yes, it is a chiral center. So my answer would be one. But if we change the molecule a little bit, we'll see something different. So I'll follow the same procedure. Circle all the carbons. That's basically all of everything. This is entirely made of carbons. Let me delete the carbons touching a double bond. I just have these two now, so I can delete them. The next step is going to be to take out carbons that have two or more hydrogens. So this one is 3, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2. I'm left with these, and I know that they only have space for one hydrogen because a carbon bonds with four, has four spaces for a bond. So they've got 1, 2, 3, and then of course that last one is not drawn. It's still a hydrogen. I'm supposed to know that it's there, even though it's not drawn in. Okay, so now I have to kind of check my work. Are these carbons really attached to four different groups? This is one group, my hydrogen is my second group. But if I look at this 3 and 4, I actually see that they look identical. There's no way to tell between this side and this side. It's exactly the same. If I look at this carbon, I have one group is just a carbon, another group is just a hydrogen. Again, this side and this side of my molecule are identical. There's no way for me to tell. And for that reason, our answer is 0 chiral centers. So after we go through these processes of elimination, we have to always go back and double check the symmetry. Using the rules of process of elimination, it looks like these two would count as chiral centers. However, we need to double check. Because of this symmetry, they look exactly the same on both sides. Neither of them are chiral centers. My answer is 0.